Welcome. My name is Stefan Müller and I'm a member of the SAP Business by Design product management team. In this short video, we would like to introduce the analytics related enhancements to IFRS 15 and ASC 606. In a nutshell, we will describe three additional reports. We will demonstrate the integrated navigation and drill down capabilities to more detailed reports and give an overview of the enhanced data sources. Find three additional reports in the Cost and Revenue Work Center in the report list, and I flagged them as priority reports just to highlight three new reports: the allocation base, a list report with key figures on actual postings and revenue recognition results, and a detailed report for a single revenue accounting contract explaining the structure. So we will start first with the revenue accounting contract list showing the allocation base. This report provides a list of revenue accounting contracts to show the allocation amounts, the transaction values in the order, the standalone selling price used as a distribution base for the transaction value, and the assigned documents. It provides two views, allocation details, and a dedicated view to show which items of the contract do not take part in the allocation. This report allows you to select by company or a single customer or a dedicated revenue accounting contract. It also allows to identify which sales document is incorporated in which revenue accounting contract. Let's execute the report. And the view we have chosen is the initial view up here. You can see the associated revenue accounting contract. In case it's maintained, its label, the structural information about which performance obligations exist, the associated sales order or customer contract, the product, and then multiple key figures: what is the ordered quantity, what is the transaction price, and information on the split, the standalone selling price used, and then as a result, the allocated amounts. A second, more detailed and specific view has been provided to identify which items are not subject to allocation. So these items behave like that the transaction price, standalone price, is taken as granted. They do not participate in any further allocation of the allocated amounts. And this allows you, for example, to identify special cases with expense items or other items that shouldn't be included into the allocation. The second report we would like to introduce is a list of revenue accounting contracts with a key figure overview. The purpose of this report is to show in a key figure overview revenues, costs, or for example balances, contract assets, contract liabilities, deferred values for costs and for revenues. Two views have been provided out of the box. One to see it in a key figure structure, and on the other side a drill down for the entire contract by GL accounts. To start the report, we open it up and briefly explain the selection criteria. So you have the capability to decide up to which key date the posting should be considered. You can select a customer, a set of dedicated revenue accounting contracts you are interested in, filter in rare occasions on the GL account or the GL account origin. In order to see more key figures, we'll just collapse the selection. So this report is grouped by customer. In order to see a few key figures more, we will remove the customer for the time being, temporarily, and have a list of revenue accounting contracts we are looking at. Which key figures are shown? As an aggregate, the net sales realized revenue, The deferred net revenue and case revenue recognition hasn't run. The realized costs, costs before revenue recognition, and in case needed, the contract assets and liabilities after revenue recognition. The navigation capabilities allow you to navigate to the UI of a single revenue accounting contract or to navigate passing by the selected revenue accounting contract to a detailed report showing the same key figures by structuring it according to performance obligation and contributing sales order items. Furthermore, you can jump to sales document light items or a detailed sales accrual report passing the necessary. In order to keep the report condensed, we have introduced structured key figures. By expanding the structured key figures, you are able to see the portion of revenue and discounts, and the same applies to the deferred net revenue, where you can also see the portion of deferred revenue and deferred discounts. The second view that is delivered by default is a drill down by GL account. This report serves the purpose to identify which GL accounts have been affected by the revenue recognition accounting contract overall. The third report provided a report for a single revenue accounting contract. It will show the revenue accounting contract according to its performance obligation structure with associated key figures. It shows the same key figures but allows a structural analysis for a single revenue contract. Four views have been provided: an overview for revenue, for costs, a drill down by GL accounts, and an overview for contract liabilities and contract assets. So usually the detailed report can be accessed via navigation from the overview report. By selecting a cell where an individual revenue accounting contract is displayed, you simply can navigate to this report, passing all parameters to further analyze the details. The report will open up with having passed the parameters. In order to get a better overview, we close this selection again, and we initially have a look on the standard view of revenue. Here we can see that on a compounded obligation, revenue have been realized and no deferred revenues still exist. The second view to look at would be probably costs. Also here we get an overview on the costs and that all deferred revenues have been realized. The situation for liabilities, there are still contract assets left, so then must be a revenue recognition run to clear the results. And finally, a more detailed view by GL account to better understand what's happening by individual performance obligation. There's a drill down by performance obligation, per set document item, and GL account to better assess on a GL account level what can be done. If further granularity is needed, there's always the possibility to add additional characteristics, like probably the journal entry that contributed to the individual GL account. From here, you could potentially navigate to the journal entry itself. If you are interested in a more granular review, you also could jump here to very granular detailed analysis. For example, by using a sales document line item report with passing all relevant criteria, GL account, sales document item, associated performance obligations, revenue accounting contract, and set of books, for example. To summarize the proposed navigation, following illustration shows you how these reports are intended. There are two entry points: the revenue accounting contract list allocation basis to assess the correctness of the revenue accounting contracts. From here, you can navigate either to the revenue accounting contract UI or drill down currently to the sales document line item. The second main entry point is the revenue accounting contract list key figure overview in order to identify issues or unexpected values for validation. On the one hand side, you can navigate to the UI, and on the other hand side, there's a capability to navigate to the detailed report revenue accounting contract list for a single revenue accounting contract that drills down by performance obligations. And from here, then for further detailed analysis, a sales document line item report is intended to be used. And for the final assurance where certain values originate from, usually a navigation to the journal entry is possible over here. As said, these are just suggested navigation pattern. Other navigations are valid as well, but this is how these reports were designed and intended to be used. I added additional characteristic, the creation date of an associated rug, and select for the last 7 days the ones affected by this cluster. And I'm actually interested in what happened to this one. I will just navigate to the performance obligation structure in order to identify the structural information, switch to a view I'm most familiar with, for example, the revenue part. And from here, I would like to understand a little bit more in depth what happened to this product on this line item, and therefore navigate to the sales document line item. All filter criteria like the sales document, but also the associated performance obligation have been passed to the underlying detailed report. And from here, I can understand in depth which postings actually affected and resulted over here. And in case I'm interested in a dedicated posting of revenue recognition, I could, for example, navigate to the journal entry and get a full picture with a couple of navigation steps. Final area I would like to highlight are the enhanced data sources. Sales ledger line items has been enhanced, project line items has been enhanced, the project cost and revenue aggregated view has been enhanced, and two dedicated new data sources have been added. It's the performance obligation master data, and it's the revenue accounting contract itself master data. What does enhancement actually mean? It means that for reports that are based on these sources, no new dedicated views have been added, but either by personalization or by key user analytics means, additional characteristics can be pulled in. To illustrate this, it shows here in a personalization UI that for these mentioned data sources before, you can pull in a new dimension with associated characteristics. The associated performance obligation and associated revenue accounting contract reflect the association based in CRM, whereas the performance obligation itself and revenue accounting contract is a trace that is left with the revenue recognition runs and the associated journal entries that at the point in time where the revenue recognition realized certain values, they originated from this revenue accounting contract and POB. So how can these enhanced data sources be utilized either by personalization or by key user capabilities? In order to illustrate this, we will use the example of a sales document line item. So how are users now able to pull in additional information they need for IFRS 15? You select this upper flag and go to add fields. By this, you get an entire catalog of added fields. And over here, the mentioned characteristics are available with their attributes you're probably interested in, and you can include them by clicking them over here as to be displayed in report, or whether they are subject to selection of your report. By this, the pool of available characteristics is enhanced. And then, after you have run a report, for example, you could decide over here to add these characteristics to your views or manipulate those. The result could, for example, be a view by key users dedicated for revenue accounting contracts like this. But this is subject to the customer implementation. This concludes the presentation of the IFRS 15 ASC 606 enhancements concerning analytics.